Well, La Paz is built on basically the side of a mountain. The hills are everywhere.
The city's alive all the time with all different cultures, all different flavors, all different colors, all different everything. I've always wanted to go on one of these ethos trips. Be able to have that opportunity in a place such as Bolivia. It's just a unique experience.
I believe that life is beautiful. To try to share happiness is the most important thing. It's not for us just to give a leg. We want to give hope. Well, until now, in these last 10 years, we have helped 480 patients. To me, they lost the leg, but nothing else. They can do everything. With our prosthetics, they can have a normal life.
I'll wake up in the morning, have coffee like on the stove. So I get my like morning cup of coffee before we leave and walk to Funprobo. Have the coffee and be out the door. Anything that happens at Funprobo is kind of on a day-to-day basis. Whatever is like the pressing task at hand.
We just kind of saw that it was in the other room and no one was really using it because it was too wobbly. So we just took it upon ourselves to go ahead and fix it. Here, nothing's considered trash. There's always a purpose. Even when we've been fixing things, we've just been looking for different scraps that they had. To my understanding, there's a pretty big stigma against people who are disabled here. Ivan was showing us the prosthetics that people came in with that they had been wearing for years, just so it would look like they had a leg.
Even in the streets, they don't care for them. If they have to take a bus, they might be waiting hours, hoping that some car is going to stop. Well, somebody called me for Victor. She told me that Victor was having a bad moment. He lost a leg and it was so hard for him. At the beginning, he wanted to die because he thought that everything was finished for him. He used to be so active before. He used to play football. And after he lost the leg, he wasn't able to do anything. Everything changed for him.
There's really no other place in Bolivia that does any other type of work like this. It's definitely different than any sort of prosthetic work you'd see done in the US. The technology is pretty limited, and they have no problem utilizing the limited resources that they have.
Sometimes their materials in-house will work almost as well as just getting something brand new.
They don't really ever throw anything out, even things like shoes and clothes that they have there to give to some of these patients. Ivan always says, you guys might think this is trash, but to some of the people here, it's pretty big treasure. This is a prosthetic for an above-the-knee amputation. So it has this mechanical knee system in here.
Before coming, we had the knees shipped to us, so we ended up bringing him down when we came.
This locking mechanism will allow him to lock it so he can walk quicker. But when they make them themselves, which they do know how to do and they do oftentimes, they aren't able to do that. For this case, this specific knee was a better option.
We almost finished everything for Victor. Now we are just putting the things together, and I believe that this afternoon we are going to start walking. Siempre que voy a subir, me aseguro que esté bloqueado y subo con la pierna buena. Simplemente yo hago esto, aquí es donde se me va a bloquear. ¿Ya? Ahí, muy bien. Muy bien, voy resbalando, perfecto.
Okay. I think with doing a program like ETHOS, it seeks to more so change the person. Working with people and helping people is definitely something I want to continue to do.
It's just so eye-opening for me that no matter what I do, I'm just going to keep learning more and more. You can make an impact in engineering. I think that's what our purpose is.
We are changing their lives. To me, that's something that I work for. When they come sad, without any desire to still living. When they live here, they come out from this place thinking on what they are going to do. They feel what I always say. You lost the leg, nothing else. Nothing else.
Thank you.